my name is Paresma Patel. I actually go by Pinky. And right now we're in the labs at NCATS and a chemistry lab in Rockville, Maryland. So I'm actually working on a disease right now. We're developing some molecules that could be of interest for fibrodysplasia ossificans progressiva, which is a rare genetic disease. I would say growing up, I've honestly wanted to be everything from an artist to a lawyer to a doctor. So I've had a breadth of interest over when I was growing up. I really did not enjoy my first chemistry class. It was a huge class. It was General Chemistry 1. It was 8 o'clock in the morning. There were 250 students, and the professor just put up transparency after transparency of chemical equations, and I just couldn't understand how I would ever use this stuff. And I spent some time at a small pharmaceutical company, and it was that time where I actually was involved in drug discovery and medicinal chemistry and applying organic chemistry to making molecules that were useful to medicine and to solving biological problems. You know, I only spent a little bit of time doing that, but that's how I knew I really liked this application of organic chemistry to medicine, and that's what I wanted to do. You do hear a lot of adages about don't trust a chemist that can't cook, because a lot of what we do is so similar. First, you have to have an idea of what you're gonna make. You read a recipe to decide how you're gonna make it. You gather kind of all the ingredients that you're gonna need, and you mix them together, and you make your end product. So similarly, with chemistry, it's a similar path. So I start off by designing an experiment, making a really specific molecule that I'm interested in. And so in order to do that, I have to do research and read a procedure in the literature. And based on what that procedure says, I actually gather all the starting chemicals that I'll need. And as chemists, we spend a lot of times actually going through this mixture that we have in a flask and trying to separate the things we want from the things we don't want. And then once we've done that, either it could be a home run and, you know, it worked the first time, or it could be a procedure that needs modification. So I might need to change and tweak a few things so I can do it again, or I might just have to move on to something else. And in the end, we spend a lot of time trying to figure out if we made what we wanted to make, whether we can make use of what we have. Sometimes when we're running chemical reactions, we need these reactions to actually be very cold. And so when you make a bath of dry ice, and in this case we're using acetone as the solvent, it actually cools the flask to minus 78 degrees. And so that allows us to run reactions under very cold temperatures. And a lot of chemical reactions, you have to keep the reaction very cold so that the chemicals that you're using don't decompose while you're running your reaction. So in this case, I'm just cooling down my flask before I add the chemicals to actually run the reaction. It's those small steps of when I kind of have an idea that I hadn't had before, or where something really works, that keeps me going, and to be able to build upon that. If you're making an antibiotic compound, for example, just testing it to see whether it kills bacteria, those are short-term effects that you learn from and you actually can develop into something more interesting down the line. For me, it would be exciting for it to be something that affects patients in the end. I'm actually somebody who is a people person. I think science is much more useful if you're interactive with people.
Are you drawing the starting quinoline starting material?
Maybe we can start with this quinoline, and then we can do a displacement maybe with an aniline. There's a lot out there, and the more you're communicating with people. I don't know if this is gonna work.
Well, that's the whole purpose.
The better of a scientist you're gonna be. Science is a career where there are a lot of times where failure is part of it. You learn from the failures. Don't let other people kind of discourage you if it's something that you want. It's possible, and you just have to put your full heart into it.